Hello everyone, my name is Eduardo. I am a proud veteran paratrooper of 22 years of military service who fought in combat for this nation three separate times. I currently live in Michigan and I continue to serve at a different capacity. I am a veteran services navigator who assists fellow veterans like myself with their personal needs and struggles in the area of mental health. I'm also a pastor in the Southern Baptist Convention, which means that theologically and politically speaking, for the most part, I'm pretty conservative in my views. In fact, I used to be a Republican, but now that I can no longer recognize the party, I switched to be an independent. So given that background, I would like to communicate with any Christian or veteran who might still be undecided about what to do on this upcoming election. I would like to present a few questions for you to consider before you cast your vote this upcoming November. So first off, to my fellow conservative Christians who love Jesus and his kingdom, when have lying, cheating, and bullying ever been acceptable Christian traits that we should be endorsing as believers? And the second question is this: do you still believe today that Christian values such as personal character and integrity and humility and love for neighbor and for the basic dignity of all human beings and grace and justice and truth to be negotiable or conditional at any time or capacity? You see, the reason I ask this question is because as a fellow follower of Christ and as a pastor that I am, it's hard for me to understand how any of us at this point who cherish these values could still vote for someone who has consistently demonstrated to be the antithesis to those values during the past 4 years. And we all know who we're talking about. The truth is that Donald Trump does not care for any of us, let alone for our good Lord's agenda. The only agenda that he really cares about is that of his own kingdom. He's using us for his own particular selfish gains. And I'm not sure if you have noticed, but he's destroying our witness and credibility all across the land. The damage that he's causing right now to our faith community will be felt among our churches for generations to come. The truth is that if we Christians allow him to stay in power, once he's reelected, he will no longer have a need to listen to us, and he will dump us and dispose us just like he does with everyone else who stopped serving his own selfish purposes. So far, he has shown us that to him, loyalty is one-way street. So now, to my fellow veterans, I just have one single question. Do you still believe today that the Constitution that we all at least once swore to uphold and defend against all enemies, foreign and domestic, do you still believe today that that document is important? Because as someone who served this nation for as long as I have, and as someone who serves you and shared your struggle, it is very hard for me to understand how any of us at this point will still support someone like Trump and his enablers who have been actively working toward the denigration of that constitution and its rule of law as he tries to act like a king who cannot be held accountable rather than a president who isn't above the law. He is destroying the very institutions that were created and designed to protect us from someone like him. That reality just shouldn't bother me, but it should bother all of us. So here's my plea to all. Our nation is critically wounded right now. And I don't think anyone can deny that fact. People all across the land are hurting one way or another from the COVID-19 effects and from all the racial strife that we are experiencing together as a nation. In the meantime, Trump has shown that he is not capable of dealing with this crisis effectively and humanely, mostly because of his gross incompetence and carelessness and neglect and inability to see anything past himself. Because of him, the rest of the world is looking at us in disbelief. And such reality should shame us all. And that is precisely why we must change direction this upcoming November and vote for Joe Biden. Listen, I understand Biden is not a person that brings too much excitement personally, but right now he is in fact the perfect person that for the task that we need him to do on behalf of our injured nation. What we need right now is someone like him who is competent and experienced and thus can stop the bleeding and perform CPR on our dying nation. He's a man of integrity and compassion who understands our pain and struggles because he himself has experienced those things in his life. He's been around the block a couple times. He knows how the government's supposed to work. He will hire the right people. He will listen to them and make decisions based on data-driven facts rather than YouTube conspiracy. He will not be on Twitter every day insulting everyone who comes to mind or following advice from any cable news personality. And he will be able to reestablish our standing in the world. Right now, being a liberal, conservative, or Democrat, or Republican isn't that important. What matters right now is that we are all American, desperate for leadership to survive together as a nation. So comes November, the choice couldn't be any more simple. We either let Donald Trump and his enablers finish the job of killing our republic as we know it, or we choose Joe Biden, who can stop the bleeding, bring decency back into the Oval Office, and thus represent us all well as Christians, veterans, and Americans. We have no other choice but to vote Joe Biden this coming election. Thank you for your time.